Medical treatment. Hey, you go to a doctor, you get examined, you get a prescription filled. All right, medical treatment. What happens if you just go in and you get a prescription filled? Is that medical treatment? Does it make a difference? Well, that takes us to this week's case. It involves a case that arose under Family Medical Leave Act. And it's a situation in which a man who is a shift worker took 4 hours off from work. Now, he'd used up all his absences. He'd used up all his PTO, all of his sick time, everything else. But he took off for 4 hours. When his employer called him on it and said, hey, buddy, you're over all your absences. You've used up all the time you can use, and you are out of here. You're fired. And they fired him. Well, through his attorneys, he jumped up and said, you know what? Under federal law, I have a right to the Family Medical Leave Act, and that allows me to take appropriate time off to get medical care or to care for members of my family. They said, okay, that's true. So then they investigated, found out that what he did during the 4 hours that he was off is he went to his medical doctor's office without an appointment, sat down, filled out paperwork so he could be referred to another doctor, and then did get a renewal of a prescription. The employer argued that's not medical care. That's not medical care because it isn't a physician who is examining him, diagnosing him, or in any way actually prescribing, after having a visitation, any form of additional medical treatment. Well, he, through his attorneys, argued, well, what do you have to do to have medical care? I mean, I went to the doctor's office, I was filling out paperwork that was necessary so I could be referred to another doctor for further treatment. That's all part of the treatment process, and I did get a prescription renewed. Well, this found its way through the federal courts and went up to the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals. And there, the court looked at both these arguments and came away and said, well, we have to look at medical treatment. What does treatment mean? And treatment generally consists of an examination, a determination of what kind of modalities of care should be given, and actually providing that kind of care in many instances. Minimally, it consists of an examination. In this instance, none of that happened. None of that happened. Since none of that happened, there wasn't medical care, and yes, Mr. Employer, you can terminate this man for being absence without cause. All right. So that was the end of the case. So, again, what do we learn from this case? What do we learn from this case? That the kind of rights that people have under federal law is determined by, of course, the language in the law. And sometimes what we think we understand, we do not really understand because we don't take a hard look at the words. Probably the most common sense advice that we learn from this is when taking some time off from work, consult with your HR person or your supervisor and say, here's what I'm doing. I'm going to the doc because he wants to refer me to somebody else. I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. Does this sound like something that's going to be covered under the Family Medical Leave Act since I'm already out of my time? In short, clear it before you do this. Clear it before you do this. It appears from this case that one of the big problems this fellow confronted was that he didn't advise anybody other than just give them relatively short notice, I'm going to take some time off from work. As in all things, communication goes a long way. Communication goes a long way. But we also see how rights that we think we possess really are highly dependent upon specific definition of the words involved, words by which the law is written. Okay, I'm David Allen. We're here every week, as you know, telling you how the law works. I'm David Allen.